Before Akbar speaks, and then we're giving the stage over for those who are fighting for immigrant rights, and it turns out that they're here also. But as Akbar is starting to speak, we're going to begin marching out of that side of the park. In other words, you have to turn around and march that way, and not instantly, because you have to hear his words, but as soon as he's done, or you think he's almost done, let's begin to march. We're going to march to the Washington Post. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful. Quickly, I know that we are over time. And I want to say this. My name is Akbar Muhammad. I'm the international representative for Minister Louis Farrakhan and the Nation of Islam. Minister Farrakhan sends you his love and greetings. If he was not faced with some health challenges, he would be right here on this stage, lifting his voice against the slaughter that's going on in Gaza. And I want to say this, America represents a ship at sea without a captain at the helm. And whichever way the wind blows, and the winds are the handlers of Barack Obama. We all loved him when he came into office. But for him to show weakness in the face of the slaughter in Gaza is appalling. We need to say, Barack, be your own man. You know that it's wrong. You know what people are suffering. You're looking at it on the news every night. You know that collective punishment is against the law. You know that the Israelis have a design. 3 wars in 5 years, killing nearly 2,000 Palestinians each time in order to decimate their ranks. But he also knows that every time a Palestinian child watches his family wiped out, that do you think that he's going to come and say, I'll forgive you, America? It's going to be in his blood that I must take revenge for what has happened to my people. The Palestinian people must resist. I just want to take a minute. Look at the weakness of Egypt. On Monday, the heads of state from all over Africa will be here. They should take a page from 1973 when the OAU told the African leaders, send your Israeli ambassador home and bring your ambassador back and close their embassy to show their protest. They need to show that strength today. And if Barack sees that the world is upset with him standing by. One more thing I want to say. When he came out for a press conference for the Ukraine crisis, he started off by saying, Israel has the right to defend itself. Israel has the right to kill babies. Israel has the right to kill old men and women and wipe out entire families. No, it's absolutely wrong, and we must lift our voices out. Free Palestine! Free Gaza! As-salamu alaykum, thank you.